Seeing our world in color can be something many of us take for granted. For example, most of you can tell that my shirt is orange without much thought. But that's not always the case for people who are colorblind. So in this week's How It Works, I'm getting a look at how our eyes help us see color and how doctors can tell if someone is colorblind. Today we're getting some insight into our eyes and we're gonna talk about color blindness. So I am with Dr. Volpe, who's got all the answers for us. But I think before we start talking about what color blindness is, we need to talk about how the eyes see color.
Sure, the perception of color actually, of course, involves the whole eye.
In your retina, where you have three different types of cones that are sensitive to different visual pigments, that all are sensitive to different colors, red, green, and blue. And the composite of putting the signals from those cells together makes color, which is actually ultimately perceived in our brain.
Okay, so explain color blindness. Is that those signals, all of the signals are not working?
So color blindness falls generally into two categories. One category is the kind that you're born with. They're missing a specific gene that's responsible for the photopigment in those specific cells in the retina. So they don't have the ability to send a different signal to the brain. And that's where the confusion between red and green or blue and yellow can occur. There are certain diseases, specifically diseases of the optic nerve, the retina, and some of the degenerative diseases that affect the brain that can cause you to lose color vision in one or both eyes as an acquired problem. And that's why we often screen for color blindness as part of figuring out why people don't see and what kind of vision problems they may have.
So if you're colorblind, I would assume that it's going to affect your daily life.
To the extent that picking clothing, recognizing red and green traffic lights, looking at instrumentation, those are situations in which color may be affected. We should point out that colorblind doesn't mean that the world appears black and white. It's just that the hues have less intensity. People who are colorblind may see things on a different spectrum, but they may actually have trouble telling a red light from a green light. There's just some modifications that people have to be careful.
I would love to take the test.
Okay. Let's do it. You'll see it's just a series of dots and designs that have different colors that accentuate one's ability to distinguish one image within another. And then we simply ask the patient to tell the number that they see.
12.
Right, so that means we see well enough.
7. 45.
Good, and then we switch to the other eye because remember we always want to test one eye at a time. I would generally do 4 or 5 with each eye just to keep person, to make sure they're not doing a memory test.
Right. 8, 5, 29, 45, 2, nothing.
Nothing, good. And that's how we assess color vision.
Cool. Biggest takeaway is if you are maybe doing your own test or you're seeing something that's concerning to you as far as your vision and even seeing color, then see a doctor.
Sometimes as described by a patient, things look washed out or gray or dark with one of my eyes. That's a very important observation to make and to see an ophthalmologist.
And this test, really simple, really easy, no pain.
No pain.
Love it. Thank you so much. Great information. For more information on how medical procedures work, just head to our website, livinghealthytv.com.